Hooray, the new integration for Google Analytics 4 in Shopify is now available. It's a native connector, so presumably you don't have to pay any money, and you can just enter your tracking ID and Shopify would integrate Google Analytics 4 for you, and then you would be gathering all the information that we would need for your e-commerce store. Now, native integrations are super convenient because with a few clicks, you have Google Analytics installed and hopefully the best integration possible for that specific platform. But the drawback might be that you are not able to customize your implementation in a way that is actually possible from the tool vendor from Google Analytics side. So today I wanted to take a first look at this new GA4 connector inside of Shopify and see what it can do for Shopify owners. And with that, I'm already logged into my Shopify store right here. And previously you might have gone to your online store and then under preferences and entered your UA code right over here. So you would add your Google Analytics UA code in this box. That is no longer needed. You could actually double tag this and put your UA code in here and leave that in here. But now for GA4, you actually need to go with the Google Channel app and configure it from there. Now this is free to install. And once you have it installed, you get to this interface here. You need to connect your Google account, give it all the permissions that it asks you to, and then you can connect your Google Analytics 4 property, whatever you have available here. For me, this one is already here. If you don't have one, you can create a new one right over here. Then all you need to do is click connect, and voila, we now have apparently Google Analytics 4 installed on our Shopify store. Let's try this actually out. I'm gonna go to my Shopify store. And let's pick one of my trusted extensions here. I'm gonna open up the developer tools. So you can also click here in Chrome under more tools, and then you have here the developer tools. And I have a tool installed here called the GTM debugger, and that will give me all the data that I would need. So I can start debugging here. It will reload the page and it will show me what it sends over to Google Analytics 4. And by default, we have many different events here already, sending over to Google Analytics 4 right here. So let's go to Google Analytics 4 and we have the page view that is firing automatically. So that's already a great start. We have a page view being sent over to Google Analytics 4. Now inside of GA4, we should also be able to see that by going into our debug view, and you can find that under your admin settings right there. And then you go over to the debug view right here. And then you see the events coming in, and here's our page view that just fired. Now, what is the information that we are looking for right here? If this new native connector is as good as the Universal Analytics connector, then we'll get some customizations out of the box and there will be some e-commerce information sent over to Google Analytics 4. So what is that e-commerce information? Well, you can actually look it up in the documentation itself. So if you install Ecommerce measurement, then you need to have these data layers set up. And then we have events like view item list. We have things like select item and so on. It's a bit hard to see here. We have actually a sheet inside of our Measure Masters program that we give to our students. So here we have the add payment info, add shipping info. These are all the Ecommerce events that you want to have installed on your Ecommerce GA4 implementation. Obviously the purchase is super important, the view item, for example, or if somebody is going through the checkout in a certain sense. And that data, just to be able to show you this, is then also available inside of your normal reports here under monetization. Then we have here e-commerce purchases. So in order to get this filled out correctly, we have a demo account here, so not much data. We actually need to install all of these codes normally onto our e-commerce store, but with Shopify and the native integration, hopefully it will do this automatically. So let's actually check a few things here on our implementation. I'm gonna go to a category page where we are right now, and we can see there was a page view event. All right, let's go to GA4 here. We had a page view event, but no list item event where we would actually see the list that is generated here itself. Again, that would be one of these events where you would have view list item and you would have all of your different categories in there and the products that have been shown to the user. So that's not available. What happens if you click on an actual item right here? And let's take a look into our debugger again. Need to start the debugger again, GA4. We see here we have two events. This time we have the page view and then also the view item. So that apparently is already sent over custom. It's not something that you would normally see on a website if you don't have the right data layers installed. So that's already a great addition. And let's put that into cart. What happens when I click add to cart? We actually get an add to cart event as well. So that is also great to see. And then we want to actually view our cart. And here I would expect a event. We get a shopping cart, but that's not a event in a certain sense. It's called shopping cart. I don't think that is coming from an integration. Maybe that's coming from the theme itself. It's definitely no GA4 event that gets sent over because it's not under the standard of GA4. So let's go ahead and then go into the checkout. And here we are dealing with a long-standing problem with Shopify. On the actual checkout pages, we don't have any tracking installed for privacy reasons or just company internal that the company said we don't want to have any tracking codes on these pages. Let me put in some test data here and go through that. Unfortunately, no tracking is firing, so we also don't have page views on this page. I'm going to continue here, and then I'm going to put in card number. We are here with the bogus card gateway, and then we go to pay now and we get to the thank you page. And here I would expect another page view, but I don't see anything here. Let me go over to the console. Yeah, we actually get a data layer push event purchase. This actually happened. So I'm not sure why the extension didn't pick that up, but this extension actually does. So we are getting more information in here, and inside of our GA debugger, we should also see that information come through. So yeah, we had a purchase, and then we also had a page view as well. So which page views was that? Page location? No, this is the thank you page checkout information. So this is simply the checkout, and the previous page path was processing. So you get the processing step and you get the thank you page step, but none of the previous steps in there. And we can see we get payment info right here. So that's also an event that Shopify sends over to Google Analytics. We have begin checkout. Other than that, we have add to cart and user engagement. So there's some events actually missing. So first of all, when we looked at the view, the list, I would expect this to be seen there. That's not the case. We have the view items. We have the add to cart, which is up here. We don't have the view cart. And then other items, add to wishlist, we don't have that in our store, but I don't presume that this is actually being recorded as well. We don't have add payment info, but we had add shipping info, if I'm correct. Let's recheck that one again. Add payment info. So we had add payment info, but no shipping info. Then did we have begin checkout? Yes, we had the begin checkout as well. So we can tick that off. A refund is something you would need to do individually. Remove from cart, we could actually try this out in a second here. A select item and select promotion is also something that is not being tracked. And then also the view promotion, as these are a little bit more complex cases or customized cases, I would say, that maybe Shopify cannot always pick up on. So we get a good chunk of these events, but not all of them. And let's actually try out if we get the remove from cart. So I'm going to just go in and put this one into my cart. I'm going to view the cart and now remove that one. So let's see if I'm getting the information now. No new event here. We had the view item, add to cart, but then no other thing. So this one is also not being tracked, but the purchase is being tracked, which is super important. All right, overall, I think this is a really cool step forward in the right direction for a lot of Shopify owners. If they want to switch over to GA4, they can do so very easily right now, and they can get some really cool extra data into their GA4, which was not previously available. But if you want to go further with your tracking and really look at the numbers, I would encourage you to get the other events sorted as well. And unfortunately, you won't be able to do this with the native connector. So you would need to go with a third-party plugin that you can install onto your Shopify store, or get the right data layers installed on your page, presumably through a developer. So you'll be able to handle all your tracking, for example, through Google Tag Manager, and forward that data onto GA4, customize the implementation to your needs. So again, I presume that a lot of beginners in tracking would just use the native integration. It is quite good, but not complete. And there are some stuff to be desired here. So if you want to go advanced, then you probably want to not use this implementation and actually go with your own implementation of Google Analytics 4 onto your Shopify store. If you are not running on Shopify store and don't have these plugins available and you're running on a different store, I have actually made a video earlier this year where I showed you how to set up e-commerce tracking for GA4. So check that out as well. Now, I hope this video helped you out. Give us a thumbs up if you liked it, and I'll see you in the next one.